Hey, what's up everyone? Danny here. In this video, I'm going to talk about Muay Thai basic footwork. Someone's asked me, they've just recently started a Muay Thai program, and unfortunately with the pandemic, all the gyms are closed. So the lady asked me, what can she do to improve the basic footwork of Muay Thai, and if there's any drills? Of course there are. I'm going to show you guys just that. Okay, so let's start here. The first thing you want to do is always assess the width between your feet and your stance, all right? So I always recommend, let's go quickly, is just the shoulder width. So the distance that you have from your shoulders, that's going to be the alignment with your legs. And now from here, if you're a southpaw or orthodox, I always like to call it, or right-handed to keep it simple, like I am, you're just going to take a left foot forward. Now, one thing to remember when we walk in Muay Thai is we don't want to cross our feet. It's normal for us to walk like this. Everyone's used to this stuff. We have balance when we do this. But now we have to be able to move forward and backward without crossing our feet. So the way to do this is very quickly is place your feet aligned with your shoulders and take one step as if you're going to start to walk, and then take an added step once again. And that should pivot you right into your Muay Thai stance. Okay, so there's going to be different ways to adjust your stance more technically. If you have a Muay Thai coach, they'll be able to assess maybe the length of your legs or your height, or you know, if you're slimmer or wider or whatnot. But in essence, this is what it is. Now, my front foot is always going to be pointing towards my opponent forward, and the back foot's going to be on a 45. One thing that's important when I talked about not crossing your feet is we're going to do a small exercise. Just practice this. Do 5 steps to the front, and then we're going to do 5 steps moving back. So I call this marching. All I'm going to do is with my hands up is just march towards the front. So watch this. Quick step with my left, and then with my right. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5, and I've stopped here. Now, when I wanna go backwards, it's gonna be the same thing, but I'm gonna lead with my back leg, in this case, my right leg. So I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, right? So if I march forward, my lead leg moves first, and then when I march backwards, my back leg moves first. When I wanna switch stances, switching right lead, what I want to do is always move my lead leg and then move the back leg right after. Okay, so now we have what we call the southpaw stance, or if someone is left-handed. Okay, so left side is going to be the power side now towards the back. Okay, and I want you to practice this as well. So we're going to be here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and moving back, same thing, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. That's it, simple, right? So the idea is just to accustom you to not cross your feet. When we move forward, a big common mistake from the side is this. I want to move towards my opponent, and people do this. For 1 second, my feet are close together. And that, if I get caught with a push kick or a jab or any type of Muay Thai attack, I'm going to get knocked down to the ground, okay? So I always want to be in a good balance. When you switch your feet, it brings you to one side or the other. That also means that I need to learn how to move using strikes. So the basic way, the fundamental way, is this. I'm going to have my hands up. I'm going to take 1 step and jab. 2 and jab. 3 and jab. 4 jab. 5 jab. Notice I made a stop for a second before I threw my jab. And now when I move back, it's going to be the same principle. Watch this. Footwork first. 1 and reset. Left jab. 2. Boom. 3. Boom. 4. Boom. 5. Boom. Switch stance. And I'll do the same thing with a right lead, right? So I'm going to go 1. Stop. And jab. 2. Stop. Jab. 3. 4. And 5. And then reverse, 1, reset. A lot of people will do this. They punch at the same time they move back. Causes 2 mistakes. Number 1, I'm off balance. Number 2, how can I punch when I'm projecting my weight backwards? That doesn't make sense. I think I talked about that in a previous video, but the principle is always move your feet, reset your balance, and then attack. Okay, so one more time backwards. I go 1, 2, 3. Bum, bum, bum. All right? This is just mechanics to teach you how to properly learn the basics at the beginner level. Then we add more stuff. But at the beginning part, this is what you should be practicing in real Muay Thai. Once we learn how to do this, we want to be able to throw combinations. What combinations will do for you is reset, or sometimes we call it reloading, on the same side. As an example, a basic 1-2, left, right, and I'm back into my stance, right? Then I'll move forward, throw it again, move forward, throw it again. So let me show you five times, right? So I go one, jab, cross, two, one, two, step, step, punch, punch, step, step, punch, punch, and again, punch, punch. When I move back, don't forget, just like on the jab, we want to reset our feet before we throw our punches. So don't do this. Okay? See, I'm already off balance. So the idea is I gauge distance, I move back, and then I reset to attack. I'm moving back, resetting to attack. One, two, one, two. One, two, one, two. One more. Bum, 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 bum. Reset your balance from the core, from the shoulders, from the hips, from the knees, from the ankles to throw your punches. All right? Then you'll want to switch your stance and practice the same thing in the opposite side. So once I'm here, I do my five, switch my stance, and then I'll do it again. One, two, one, two. Move forward and punch. Moving back, reset and punch. Moving back and punch. Always reset your balance before you throw your punches. That's really important at the beginning stages to understand. Most of my students spend at least a year training this type of stuff, and that's super important. Then, when they reach the advanced level, it's super easy to teach the advanced techniques because they have this cemented down. This is super important. Just like a building, if we have concrete slabs and the ground is super solid, then you can start adding the decorations on the top, and it's going to be solid, right? You don't want to do everything backwards. So, once you have this down, I have another drill for you. Is you can learn how to move sideways. So sideways, meaning left or right side, is gonna be the same principle. If I'm moving towards my left because I wanna follow you in the ring, I don't wanna be crossing my foot like this. See how off balance I am? And if I'm moving towards my right, crossing my foot in front of the other. So I'm gonna widen and close. So I'm gonna be here, I'm gonna go one, two, one, two, one, two. And if I'm moving towards my right side, same thing. Widen and close. One, two, one, two, one, two. That's just basics, right? But we want to teach our bodies to just react naturally when doing this. When you're going to be moving, using your shadow boxing, working the Thai pads, and eventually Muay Thais for the ring, when you're fighting someone, you never want to be caught off guard. And by off guard, that doesn't just simply mean putting your hands down. It also means having your feet. So a good seasoned fighter usually sees this. We use what we call the peripheral vision. And as I'm looking at your chest or your eyes, I see your feet. And the moment I see you crossing your feet more than once, that's when I'm gonna start chopping those legs or attacking you with a cross. And that's when I catch you off guard. All right, so you don't wanna be surprised by being off balance simply because you don't have basic sound footwork. That's super important at the beginning stage. Even if you're not gonna be fighting in the ring, it doesn't matter. Learning Muay Thai is an art. And we want to perfect our craft. We want to perfect it so that way that when we do our shadow boxing, our heavy bag, our focus mitts and tie pads, even our partner drills, we have sound technique, we have sound balance, okay? Now I have one more drill for you. This is more intermediate, but it's good to practice at all levels. Now I showed you how to use the jab and then the jab cross. Now with the 1-2, we call this reloading on the same side. So I'm going one, reset, boom, boom, reloading this shoulder right here before I start to move forward again. Now we're gonna take it up a notch and we're gonna reload, but using only one leg. So how we're gonna do this is by throwing a knee. I like to throw knees because knees, as a straight knee, is gonna keep us in alignment in front of our opponent, as opposed to round kicks such as swing kicks, all right? So if I'm using a 1-2, everything is coming in a straight line, just like arrows, right? So this is gonna help me practice my balance. So at the beginning stages, a good drill to practice is stepping forward, one, stopping, one, two, stopping, and then stepping with a straight knee. See that? So I move forward, I go one. That's the first part. Second part, two punches. And last part, straight knee. Let's see that once more. One, bum, bum. Take your time. And as I move back, same principle. Balance first, attack, balance again, and attack. Move back. Boom, boom, bam, bam, bam. Move back. Bam, 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 bam. Move back. See that? So these simple drills are going to help you with your beginning stages of Muay Thai. Muay Thai footwork, incorporating some punches, some kicks, and then you could start blending things in, such as moving forward, moving back, and then attacking. Moving to the side, moving on an angle diagonally, switching your feet, moving forward, moving back, moving to the side, maybe moving on a diagonal, and then attacking, right? So once you learn the basics, it doesn't matter, the basics will always stay with you. They always remain. And then when you start to add the intermediate stuff, the advanced stuff, and even if you're a pro fighter, the basics never go out of style. So guys, if you have any more questions on Muay Thai, send them my way. I'm gonna answer them in a future video. And for everyone else, keep training hard. We'll see you soon. Take care.